Good evening. We're preparing for worship, and so I'm going to be playing a song by Lisa Schultz, that she's playing. It's suite number 4 from Bach, so it's playing on another device, so hopefully you'll be able to hear it as we prepare ourselves for worship this evening, and so we'll begin as soon as it's done. It's about a 6-minute or so long piece, so we do thank Lisa for doing this for us.
Thank you. disciples gathered for a meal together. So we gather this night, even though we are apart. An empty chair reminds us of those who are present with us only in spirit, as well as the hope and certainty of the time when we will once again gather around this table of grace. And so I invite you to name those people where you are, those that you are missing at your own table or that you are missing as we gather at this table. While we and these loved ones are far from us, still we gather in spirit, for we are united in and through Jesus. Today begins the three great days marking Christ's passion, death, and resurrection.
We follow Christ's path with thanksgiving, knowing that he endured all because of his great love for us.
Today is the night when Jesus gathered with his disciples in the upper room.
Lord, bless us as we gather in a new way.
Today is the night when Jesus washed his disciples' feet.
Lord, teach us to love and serve one another.
Today is the night that Jesus gathered at the table with those closest to him.
Lord, we gather at our own tables, mindful of what unites us.
Today is the night of Jesus' betrayal and arrest, the night which leads to the cross and unimaginable suffering and death.
Lord, help us to remain faithful disciples.
Tonight we remember again that death did not have the final word.
The cross was followed with resurrection joy.
Tonight we affirm again that because Christ lives, we too shall live, and that with the great cloud of witnesses we say, Amen. Come to us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Friends in Christ, in this Lenten season, we have heard our Lord's call to struggle against sin, death, and the devil, all that keeps us from loving God and each other. This is the struggle to which we are called in baptism. Within the community of the church, God never wearies of forgiving sin and giving the peace of reconciliation. On this night, let us confess our sin against God and our neighbor and enter into the celebration of the great 3 days reconciled with God and one another. We pause for a moment of reflection and self-examination. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name.
Amen.
As a sign of Christ's forgiveness and as a reminder that Jesus did kneel at the feet of his disciples to tenderly wash them, and as a reminder of our own baptisms, I invite you to wash the hands of any of those who are there who are in your own household or of yourself as we hear the reading from John. Now, before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands and that he had come from God and was going to God, he got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around them. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, Lord, are you going to wash my feet? Jesus answered, You do not know now what I'm doing, but later you will understand. Peter said to him, You will never wash my feet.
Jesus answered, Unless I wash you, you have no share with me. Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash, except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them."
In the mercy of Almighty God, Christ offers his whole self in love for all people. Jesus Christ was given to die for each one of us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We join in the song, A New Commandment.
A new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you love one another as I have loved you. By this shall all know that you are my disciples, if you
had purified themselves. All of them were clean. So they killed the Passover lamb for all the returned exiles, for their fellow priests, and for themselves. It was eaten by the people of Israel who had returned from exile, and also by all who had joined them and separated themselves from the pollutions of the nations of the land to worship the Lord, the God of Israel. With joy, they celebrated the festival of unleavened bread 7 days, for the Lord had made them joyful and had turned the heart of the king of Assyria to them, so that he aided them in the work on the house of God, the God of Israel. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God. The Holy Gospel according to Mark, the 14th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to them, and said, "Take, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. And Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Even though all become deserters, I will not." Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this day, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times." But he said vehemently, "Even though I must die for with you, I will not deny you." And all of them said the same. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took with him Peter and James and John and began to be distressed and agitated. And he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake." And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said, "Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me. Yet not what I want, but what you want." He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, "Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came to them and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace and peace to you from God our Father, our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Being seated as a table is something not so much new to me, but unusual for me nowadays. Not only because I'm single, but because my table, truth be told, at home, my dining room table, is filled with mail and other assorted things that I keep meaning to put away. And it's, you know, it's a good sized table, but I don't often eat there. And I also am often eating at a car table next to my chair that also has a lot of things on it that I've got to kind of move things aside so I can even put my plate down there. And I suspect many of you also don't always have the opportunity to eat at home as a family, that so many people nowadays are rushing to and fro, that there's so many things going on in our world, that eating often takes place in cars or in shifts, so that people eat at different times. But these days are affording us that opportunity to gather at our home tables with one another. We may not be able to gather around this table right now, and I'm especially mindful of Zach and Jonathan, who were to receive their first communion this night. Zach has been bugging me for years, holding out his hands to me again and again, hoping I'll just like kind of forget and slip him a wafer. He's been very anxious for that, he will get it, we promise, but it's not yet. We can't quite have communion yet together, because it is about being the community together, physically together. Because communion is a very tangible thing. It's the wine, it's the bread, we can have that all ourselves, but it's the shared meal that we come together to share with one another. Earlier today, I had a little Zoom thing, which, truth be told, also I forgot to record so other people can see it. But we talked about the Seder meal. This is also the Passover for our Jewish brothers and sisters. And they have very tangible things that they use as a part of their Seder meal. I've kept a few here kind of for my dinner because I didn't go home. The matzah cracker, of course, which is the unleavened bread that they did not allow the bread to rise so that they could be ready. There's a mixture of apple and nuts and cinnamon and a little bit of wine, which is called karaset, which is to remember the mortar that held the bricks together as they were building for the Egyptians in slavery. Also some horseradish here as a bitter herb about the bitterness of slavery. And an egg, as well as some green that I can put out here, but some green, signs of new life and new possibilities. They use these very tangible means to retell their story of how Jesus, how God freed them from slavery in Egypt, and they pass that along in tangible ways. Jesus knelt at the feet of his disciples in a very tangible way and washed their feet. Now, may not have ever had anybody wash your own feet. Even washing our own feet at times is kind of just a quick scrub in the shower. You don't spend a lot of time unless you go get a pedicure, of course. But we don't necessarily spend a lot of time on our feet. But they've walked a lot. So their feet were pretty grubby and pretty gross, probably even, of walking with sandals across the countryside. But maybe we don't do that as much. I spend more time in my car than I actually do getting my steps in every day. But I came across, and it's at the end of your bulletin, I came across something that that talks about our hands instead. That talks about saying, wash my hands instead of my feet, because our hands are often those that are living for us. And you can read that on your own, whether it's washing dishes or taking care of things, it's paying bills or gardening, it's stroking a child's head or a handshake. And so our hands do many things. Right now we can't touch. Dawn and I are six feet apart, give or take. We can't touch, even though we're close. But we know the importance of a touch, of Christ's touch, both on their feet, but also in the midst of our community together. Jesus gave the commandment. The word Maundy comes from command, to love one another. And for us right now, not touching is the most loving thing to do. It seems so out of character or contrary to who we are, especially for all you huggers out there, you know who you are, that want to hug, that want to show that sign of tangible affection. But right now, not touching, not coming together in community is the most loving thing to do. And we know that no matter where we are, whether we are in our homes or where we're at, even though we are apart, that we are gathered in Christ's name, virtually, but that we're seeking to love God through our lack of actions, by withholding a hand, or wearing a mask, or gloves, or staying home. Jesus came into the midst of this world to touch us with God's grace, but also knowing that when those touches can become not safe, Christ would withhold his physical touch too. Because what he ultimately came to was in the midst of our suffering, in the midst of the brokenness of this world, to show us the best way, to show us the most fullness of God's love for us, of what that is. And tomorrow, as we enter more fully into the Good Friday story, as we walk with Jesus the way of the cross, as we hear his final words, we know that that is God's great love revealed to us in these real and these tangible ways. And so while we can't eat together or touch one another, we know that Christ still is with us and loves us and forgives us and is with us always. And it's for this that we do proclaim, thanks be to God. Our next song is Eat This Bread. Hopefully I'll sing it a little better than the previous one.
I can throw you off.
No, it wasn't you threw me off. It was me. I threw myself off. So we'll just sing this through once.
Eat this bread. Drink this cup. Come to me and never be hungry.
God's presence with us, we are bold to proclaim our faith as we use the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Lord God, on this, the night he was betrayed, your Son Jesus Christ washed his disciples' feet. We commit ourselves to follow his example of love and service. Lord, hear us.
And humble us.
On this night, Jesus prayed for his disciples to be one. We pray for the unity of your church in these times when we're separated and isolated, that we use the tools that we've been given and blessed with to gather together, even if it is only virtually. Lord, hear us.
And unite us.
On this night, Jesus prayed for those who were to believe through their ministry. We pray for the mission of your church, that it continues to reach out, sharing love and comfort with those who are in most need, especially during these challenging times. Lord, hear us.
And renew our zeal.
On this night, Jesus commanded them to love, but suffered rejection himself. We pray for the rejected and unloved, for those in the darkness of loneliness. We pray, Lord, that through us, your light can shine even to those who are in the shadows. Lord, hear us.
And fill us with your love.
On this night, Jesus reminded them that if the world hated them, it hated him first. We pray for those who are persecuted for their faith, for those in places in the world where to proclaim the word of Christ brings them into physical danger. Lord, hear us.
And give us peace.
On this night, Jesus calls us to remember that we may be reconnected in faith, and as we pray as our Lord taught us, we may share in Christ's loving presence.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
While we are stripping the altar, I will be playing the song again that Lisa played, that I played at the beginning of the service. You may also then at home read Psalm 22 aloud as we are doing that. Let me just get this set up real quick.